It is Friday morning. It is the fourth day of the month of September. September 4th might not mean much to most of us, but it means a lot to people in Summers Point, because this is the day on which a New Jersey patriot named Richard Summers, after whom Summers Point is named, this is where he was from, and the crew of his ship. Now, here was a 26-year-old New Jersey man. He got control of the ship. I think he was 23. When nowadays he would be hanging out in his parents' house playing video games and puffing weed, he had become the captain of a ship in the new Navy, the new American Navy. And this was the day in 1804 that he was killed fighting the Barbary pirates. It's quite a story. Richard Summers was born and raised in Summers Point. And at one time, he was quite famous, but we sort of have lost track of that now. So I would like to resurrect it for a moment or two. For more than 1,000 years, fanatic Islamic sea fighters from North Africa had attacked ships and coastal towns from Italy clear up to Iceland, and they were capturing and selling the Europeans as slaves. More than 1 million over the period of time, are holding them for ransom if they were from families of any kind of wealth. By 1800, most European countries were paying tribute, paying bribes to the rulers of these kingdoms in North Africa, including Tripoli, to avoid the attacks. And for 15 years, the newly independent United States also did pay the protection money. We did not have a navy. Well, if you have had courses or studied American history, you'll remember that at one time, the great slogan was millions for defense, not 1 cent for tribute. So the people got behind the move, and Congress spent millions of dollars and built a navy. And enter there Richard Summers. In 1801, President Thomas Jefferson sent the navy overseas to end the attacks on American ships, primarily. And most of the warships were commanded by captains like Richard Summers, and again, some were only 23 years old when they got command. And so in Europe, our friends and enemies were ridiculing us for sending schoolboys to fight the most fanatic, well-trained fighters in the world. But the young Americans amazed the world with their strength and their bravery, and of course, what became known as Yankee ingenuity. And their victory ended the Barbary slave trade forever. And, of course, this really was also, in addition to Europeans, these same people, these same Muslim little kingdoms there, they had millions of Europeans, 15 million Africans also. So they were essentially behind the rounding up the Africans for slave trade, 15 million. So this sort of inspired, I guess, the rest of the world to take a look at slavery. And, of course, obviously it ended eventually, fortunately. But this is the day that in one of the battles, Richard Summers and his ship were killed. So to commemorate that, the ceremony, they'll have a ceremony today. It'll be at noon, and that'll be at the Richard Summers statue in front of Summers Point branch of the Atlantic County Library in Summers Point, New Jersey. There'll be a ceremony and a wreath laying ceremony at the foot of his statue. And going through the weekend, there'll be some more ceremonies. So that's something that we just really don't get taught or think about. Is American history taught in school at all, except in special occasions? Did you have it, Brian? Did you have a course in American history? We used to have to.
Yeah, I had a few of them. Yeah.
Yeah. But okay, so you did. It's still taught. Mm-hmm. Were you aware of Richard Summers?
I was. Yeah.
Oh, you were. Yeah. Okay, because you were from New Jersey.
Yeah.
All right. Well, that's great. I did
take a class on New Jersey history too.
Oh, okay. So New Jersey history. You heard of it? Great. It's 6:44. On New Jersey 101.5. And, of course, our telephone number, anytime you would like to jump into the fray, 1-800-283-1015. I was kind of amazed at the fact that these captains, some of these ships, 26 years old. Now, they did also, they had some of the party landed, as I recall, and they had a pincers movement. They were fighting at sea off the coast, and then they slipped in behind. And a relatively small handful of Americans sort of put the pirates out of business over there then. It was 1804.